Hello and welcome everyone. And in this video, we are going to talk about array in JavaScript. Okay, so what are the array? So array are like a collection in JavaScript or a type in JavaScript, which is used to store the information, a collection of information. So like if you wanted to store a number of homogeneous type, so the only constraint you have is you will be storing the information of homogeneous type, like for array. Here you are storing some numbers. Okay, so this is the array of numbers. Maybe there can be a string of array. So this can be a string array, this can be a boolean array, this can be a number array. So first let's talk about what is array, the capital A array. I'm talking about this. So array is actually a function in JavaScript. If you do a type of capital A array, it will give you that it is a function in JavaScript. So everything in JavaScript is a first class function. So it is a part of native code. And how we create a new object of this function. So consider this is a function, right? This is the function. Now this is already defined in JavaScript. And now if you wanted to create an object of this function, then we can do something like this. Using new keyword, we can create an array, or we can just simply type like this, and we will just write this expression. So this is also an array. If you do type of array, it will be an object, because array is an object. So either we can create an array object like this, or either we can create array object like array equal to using new constructor. But people don't do something like this. They can just easily create an array like this. So array is a collection of homogeneous data types. Can be a number array, string array, can be a boolean array. And here we can just create our array simply directly. So if I'm creating the number array something like this, right? Now what all different methods I can apply? So if you do a type of object is array, and how this object is created from which particular function? I'm just talking few things which I haven't talked till now, but it will help you when I'm talking the advanced topics. So here you can see console.log object, which is an array. And this particular object is created from what particular function? If you see, all the methods are here. So I will talk about this piece later, but you can see what all different methods you can apply. This is array object, and on the array object, you can apply all these methods: concat, constructor, copy within, and all. Okay, the constructor of this particular object is representing the array function from which it is created. Let's leave it if you're not able to understand it right now. So here var array equal to just a simple iteration. Okay, now let's talk about capital A array. So this is used to be a function, right? So what all different methods it is providing us? You can see all the array prototype methods. You can see array.prototype. Here you can see all the methods. So these all the methods can be applied to an array. We will talk about these prototypes, functions later, but for the initial understanding, these all these methods are available, and you can do a find, filter, fill, map, filter, for each, reduce. All these methods can be applied on an array. So here I did array dot, right? All these methods are applied because this array is an object of array function. Again, this array is a function which is having some prototypes. All these methods are there, right? And whenever you are writing this expression, what you are doing, you are actually creating an object of array function, and all the methods are available here. You can see constructor, copy within, entries, fill, for each, all these methods are here. So forget about proto and prototype for now. So we are declaring array like this. We are just putting some values inside it. So this is a homogeneous collection of data you are entering. Now what all different methods you can apply? On array, you can apply the length of that array, or there are a lot of different methods, push, pop, all these things. So if you wanted to get the array of the length of this array, then array.length. What it will give you, it will give you the length of the array, which is 5. Okay. Similarly, there are other methods like push, pop, unshift, shift, splice, slice. We will talk about all these methods one by one. So if I'm doing push new character 9, new digit 9, so let's do this here. So if you do array.length, what you will get, array.length will give you the length of that array, which is 5. Now if you do, you can see all the methods are here. Push means adding a new element to the array. Now if you do array.length, which is increased, right? Similarly, you can do a pop. Pop means popping the array element. So it works like a stack, JavaScript stack. You can see pop 9. So these are different methods. You can just do array.shift, like so it will pop the first element from the array. Similarly, if you keep popping up, it will keep popping up the elements from the starting point until unless it is undefined. Okay, I cannot write clear here. Okay, so this is how we will talk about the array. So the type of array, if you just this array, then type of this array is an object. If you want to do console.dir, what you will see now here, try to understand this part, console.dir array. So you already know that this is an object, right? So this is an array of 4 element. Now object has a proto and functions will have a prototype. So what you will see in the proto of this object, you will see all the methods, and the object constructor is actually pointing to the function who created this object. So we are creating the same object can be created by with the help of new array, right? This also do the same thing. New array, it is creating the object of the array functions, and same we are doing with the single line. Okay, so this is about the array. Next, we'll talk about the for in and for off loop in JavaScript.